the resignations in today, this afternoon. We do thank y'all so much for coming. It's really important for me to let you know how wonderful these kids are, how talented they are. And we have a cast of 21. 11 of them have never performed on stage before. They had to learn vocals, they had to learn how to tap. Only one of them had taken tap lessons before, so they're all new to that. So we just did a lot of work. In January alone, we practiced 65 hours. So that's a lot of time. So we're really close by now. I want to recognize some people. I don't know if Ms. Renee is here. Ms. Renee Oates of Renee's Dance Studio. She taught them how to tap. And then I had Ms. Miller, Tracy Miller, who's back there being a videographer today. She did the vocals. So it was a group effort. And luckily we got in there and we got it all done. After the play today is senior night, so we're going to recognize our seniors after the show and let them know how we, I'm not going to start crying, how much we're going to miss them. They've been a true blessing to me. I also want to recognize, I think Mr. Corley's here. Is he?
Top.
Where?
Back here in the back, in the shadow.
Hey, Mr. Corley. So I want to recognize him. I saw Ms. Rhodes, one of the administrators at our school. If there's any central office people that are here, I want to recognize you. Thank you all for coming. And also the parents. If you're a parent of one of these kiddos, please stand up and let them know. This week they've been really mad at me because we get to school at 6 a.m. But the parents from last year will tell you it's better than 5. So we have those long days, we do. Are there any alumni here from the NDHS Players? Go ahead, stand up. So that's always good to have them come back and see what we do. Let me try to get everything. We have entertained over 1,800 kids. We have brought live theater kids into their lives. Some of them would have never experienced this if it wasn't available here. I know a lot of times when people say, hey, you want to go see this play? And they're like, it's high school. But we're not like high school, I promise. When you leave here today, you're going to be like, that was better than a lot of colleges. Because that's how much talent we have here in Minnesota Parish. And I'm lucky enough to get to do this. I've done it for 23 years. I just pray I'm lucky to keep going, maybe forever. So just sit back, relax, and ignore the light.
Couldn't find her no more.
Well, it was
off. Annie, bring me your note.
Again?
Please.
Sure, Molly.
Here we go again.
Please take good care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She was born on October 28th. We'll be back to get her soon.
We have left half of a golden locket around her neck, kept the other half, so that when we come back for her, you will know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, another laughing.
All right, do you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Gee, I dream of having a mother and father again. But you're lucky. You really got them.
I know. Somewhere.
Good luck. Get up! Get up!
Yes, Miss Hannigan!
Now turn around. I said, turn around! There. Now, what do you say? What do you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan!
Rotten orphan!
I'm not an orphan! My mother and father left a note saying they loved me and they were coming back for me!
That was 1922. This is 1933. Get up! Now, for this one's shenanigans, you'll all get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building!
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning!
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning!
Get to work!
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
I said now!
Oh.
Why do you think you never want to be an orphan? Beyond me.
Thank you.
back there?
Nothing.
Give her!
No, no!
Your days are not a threat! All right, breakfast.
Hot mush! Yuck!
No, not hot mush.
Here.
Someday you'll have enough. afternoon, Miss Farrell.
Good afternoon, Drake. Has Mr. Robux arrived yet?
No, miss. We're expecting him any minute.
Do you really live here? Or is this a train station?
We really live here. Annie, this is Miss Drake. Miss Drake, this is Annie.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear. Now, what would you like to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them first, then I'll get to your windows.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning while you're here. You're our guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now, Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Green is her best color. No blue, I think.
Your bath is dried by Mrs. Greer.
So, no bubbles, I think.
Annette comes in to make your bed.
Silk, no satin sheet, I think.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
When you wake, ring for Drake. Drake will bring your tray. When you're through, Mrs. Pugh comes to take it away. No need to pick up any toys.
That's okay, I haven't got any anyway.
No food, no will you lift my day.
We have one more request. Please put us to the test.
Good to see you again. Miss Drake dismissed the staff.
Yes, sir.
And Grace, here's your notebook. Who's that?
This is Annie, sir, the orphan who'll be with us for Christmas.
That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just had an orphan, so I got a girl.
Suppose she'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Oh, I'm just Annie, Mr. Warbutt, sir. I haven't got any last name. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
No, of course not. I couldn't be happier. Grace, we'll start on the iron ore shipments from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with Miss Chown?
It's her first night here, sir.
Well, I suppose we ought to do something for your first night. What do you say to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Now go to the Roxy, then an ice cream soda at Rumpelmeyer's, and then a handsome cattle ride on Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about the dictation for tonight. You'll take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
It's just that, well, I wanted you to take me.
I'm afraid I'll be far too busy tonight.
Aw, gee.
Now, Annie, I've just been away for 6 weeks, and I'm a manager in a multi-billion dollar corporation.
Oh, sure. I know. It's okay, Mr. Warbucks.
Miss Drake, get our coats.
Oh, gee.
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Which car will you be wanting, sir?
The Duesenberg. No, we'll walk.
Walk? To the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Why see you, my sister? say that I'm square, but wow, I come alive.
The city's bright as a penny arcade. It blinks, it slips, it rings.
To think that I've lived here all of my life and never seen these things.
NYC.
Again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? We're both spread out for Annie already.
On the contrary, Miss Hannigan, this has to be signed and sent back to Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Well, Mr. Robux is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie, the daughter of a millionaire.
The daughter of a billionaire!
Would you excuse me for a moment, please? Got any more wonderful news?
Merry Christmas, Miss Hannigan.
Oops, pardon me, sweetheart. Ah, yes, this long time no see.
Rooster, they finally let you out of prison? What were you in for this time?
Some of you said I swindled them out $1,100.
Why do you say that?
Because the rooster swindled them out $1,100.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from
Jersey City. You got a real nice dump here.
Whatever made you want to walk in a place like this?
Love.
Brewster, do me a favor. Get out of here.
So, who's the sweetheart of a gentleman come in?
Looked like she had a couple of dollars.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
Annie, one of the orphans from here is getting adopted by.
Crummy orphan?
Yeah, living in a lap of luxury while the two handy kids ended up on the skids. It ain't fair how we scrounge for three orphan Warbucks while she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair, this year life is driving me nuts while we get peanuts. Living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to get more bucks
instead of less. Maybe she fixed the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Give you one guess.
Yes!
Easy Street.
For supper Christmas Eve. You will? Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, figure out with Democracy.
Yes, sir.
Is that package of two things?
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and tell her I want to adopt her.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her in here.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
No, of course not. Annie, I was born to a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. One day, one way or another, I was going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
But lately I've realized something. No matter how much money you have, if you have no one to spend your life with, if you're alone, then you might as well be broke. I was in Tiffany's yesterday, and I picked this up for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. Oh, gee.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear. I told myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket. Here, let's take this one off, Annie.
No! I don't want a new one!
What's the matter, Annie?
This locket, my mom and dad left it when they left me at the orphanage. And a note, too. They're coming back for me. I know I'm real lucky being here with you for Christmas. But the one thing I want in all the world is to find my mother and father and be like the other kids with bumps of my own.
It'll be all right, Annie. I'll find you. I'll find your parents.
It's okay. Mr. Bucks will find your mother and father. No matter if he has to put everyone in his organization on the job. No matter if he has to pull every string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
But Mr. Warbucks!
I understand, but it could be our best clue. I'll give it to the FBI and they'll trace it to see who bought it.
Okay. Maybe they should have my note, too.
You watch, Annie. We may be meeting your mother and father in a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, boy! I gotta write a letter to the kids about this!
What a thing
listen, okay?
So maybe now it's time.
Yes, thank you, Annie, and welcome to America's favorite radio program, The Austin Hour Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. Good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Bert Healy. It's nice to be here.
Oliver Warbucks, I understand that you have something to tell the folks at home about the little Annie here.
Yes, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 if anyone is proof to Annie's parents.
Wow!
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Ewing.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say oxygen. Yes, this is your old softie, Miss Healy's boy Bert, saying until next week.
Same time, same station. Good night.
Aw, geez. Annie on the radio? Coast to coast? She's famous.
I wish I was on the radio.
Me too.
Who wants to be on the dumb old radio?
I do. And now, from the Hour of Smiles family, this is Bert Healy saying, hey, hobo man, hey, dapper Dan, you both got your style,
but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be faux-bromely, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Who cares what? What you wear from ear to ear, and not from head to toe, then matters.
So senator, so janitor, so long for a while, remember you're never fully dressed, though you may wear your best, you're never fully dressed.
$50,000 reward. $50,000? What I couldn't do with $50,000.
Excuse us, ma'am. Are we the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah. What do you want?
Ma'am, was he working here 11 years ago?
Yeah.
Well, we had terrible troubles back then and had to leave a baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl! Our Annie!
Your Annie's parents?
Where'd you say you come from again?
Oh, a little farm up in Canada where they've got lots of chickens and ducks and geese and roosters.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones!
We need your help, sis, for details about Annie that can help us fill this thing out.
What's in it for me?
Three-way split.
Half.
Half?
Half.
Fine, 25 grand each. But we gotta do it fast. Get the money, get the kid, and get out of town.
The kid's the problem. What should we do with her afterwards?
No problem. When I want something to disappear, it disappears. For good. We'll get the 50 grand, we blow this grubby town, and Lily and I'll meet ya.
Where? Oh, yeah.
Celebration. You can have anyone in the world you want to come to it. Who would you like?
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell here. And Mrs. Drake. And Mrs. Pugh. And everyone here.
Miss Drake?
Yes, sir?
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids!
We're going to be far past their bedtime. But I'll tell you what, we'll have everyone down from the orphanage for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid!
Together at last, together forever, we're tying a knot they never can sever.
I don't need sunshine now, turn my skies to blue.
I don't need anything but you.
Yesterday's plain awful.
You can say that again.
Yesterday's plain awful.
But that's
not now, that's then. I'm poor as a mouse.
I'm richer than Midas.
But nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow I'm an apple seller too,
I don't need
anything. I don't need anything but you.
Ralph Mudge, and this here's the wife, Shirley.
And you're Annie Mudge!
Annie Mudge?
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
We've seen a great number of people who...
I expected you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Here's our driver's licenses and Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl, name Anne Elizabeth Mudge. Born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge. New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th, that is my birthday. Ralph, look! Annie's wearing the locket!
When we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half of a golden locket with her and kept the other half. Oh, yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's our Annie!
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever.
You haven't heard? I'm giving away a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who proves that his parents.
No, sir. Anyway, we don't want no money.
On the other hand, Ralph, do you remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? With $50,000, we can afford to bring Annie a bride in the country!
Would you mind if Annie stayed here for Christmas, and you come back and get Annie and the check?
Whatever you prefer, sir.
Bye, Annie love!
Until tomorrow morning, honey, and then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Oops, pardon me, sweetheart. Have a Merry Christmas.
Well, this is...
wonderful news!
We must celebrate, because we've just found out the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father, to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge! Annie!
I've lost her. I've lost Annie.
Sir, I have the strangest feeling that Mr. Mudge isn't who he says he is.
But I won't give up until we're certain.
But how?
Go straight to the top, to the President of the United States. Even if he's a Democrat.
Succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, David and Margaret Bennett.
But...
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
You mean I'm an orphan after all?
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes, because I know they loved me, and they would have come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you too. Then who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Well,
The birth certificate could have easily been forged, but no one knew about the locket except for us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan!
And Miss Hannigan!
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Hi, Miss! Hi, Annie!
Hi,
Miss
Hi, guys!
Hi,
Miss Hannigan.
Same here, and I know you anywhere.
Let me introduce you next. This is my secretary, Miss Farrell. This is Miss Drake. And this is the President of the United States.
Look, kids! There's presents here for all of us! Come here, come here!
I'm going to clear the way!
What happened to you?
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come from the FBI.
Now it all fits together.
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas. Well, we don't want to bother you on Christmas and all. We just come to pick up Annie and the check.
Yes, of course, the check. $50,000 certified.
Certified. Paid in the order of... the jig is up.
Yes! Also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Ward, turn him over.
Deck the halls with boughs
of holly. Now find this
woman in their office. I never seen these people till yesterday.
Come off, Daggy.
Annie, tell him how good and nice I always was to you.
Jeez, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan. But remember the one thing you always taught me. Never tell a lie.
I'm going to jail to deal with you.
Miss Hannigan is gone for good.
Yay!
You don't have to work anymore.
Yay!
Yes, girls. For you and for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. A new deal. Hey. I rather like that. A new deal.
So do I, Franklin. A new deal.
The sun's out tomorrow.
Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to present for the last time the
the confidant of Annie.
Thank you.